Assalamualaikum students. Today we are going to start the explanation of poetic devices of the poem. Students, we have started this poem Rain on the Roof, written by Potskin. We have completed summary of this poem about the poet and its explanation. In the explanation, I have given extra word meaning also. So you will copy that extra word meaning in your CW. Students, I said this poem written in 3 stanza. And in every stanza, the poet has used many figures of speech. So today we are going to start its explanation. What is the figures of speech and which type of figures of speech he has used in this poem? So here I have written few points of the figures of speech, and in this 3 stanza, this poem is already discussed and already given by the poet. Stanza number 1 and 2 and 3, in every stanza, this type of points referred by the poet. First is rhyme scheme, second is the rhyming words, third is personification, transferred epithet, fifth is metaphor, onomatopoeia, alliteration, and last also here 7 points repeated by the poet. So we'll see what is these all the points. In the first stanza, first of all, we'll discuss. First stanza given here, when the human shadows hover over all the strange spheres, and the melancholy darkness suddenly gives in rainy tears. What a bliss to place the pillow of a Buddhist chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain over here. Students, you have also here find that what? The few words are repeated. It means its pronunciation, not whole word, but its pronunciation repeated here. By the repetition of pronunciation, we can get the rhyme scheme and rhyming words. If you got the rhyme scheme, then easily you can find the rhyming words. So, first of all, we'll see the rhyme scheme. What is the rhyme scheme? Here, at every end of the every word, here, end of the line, one word is there that repeated its pronunciation again. So, it means we have to use the same alphabet for that pronunciation. For example, here, hover. Now, what is the first letter in our alphabet? That is the A. So, we'll write here A. Spheres. Pronunciation change. It means that hover and spheres, both pronunciation are not same. So, if not same, so we have to use the next alphabet. After A, what will come there? B. So, A, B. Here, one pronunciation, number 2. Then, darkness. Again, pronunciation change. So, after B, what will come there? C. Understood? And then, last, here, tears. Spheres, tears. You can see here, pronunciation are same. So, we have to use the same alphabet which we have used in the second line. Which we have used, that is the B. So, again, B will come. Understood? So, A, B, C, B. If we have a same pronunciation, we will write the same alphabet here. We will write the same sound here, we can say. Then, again, pillow. Again, pronunciation is changed. So, what will come after C? Because here B already came. C after what will come? A, B, C, D will come. Right? Pillow, B, A. Again, pronunciation same. A, B, C, E, D. After D, what will come there? E will come. Pattern. After E, what will come? F will come. Bed and overhead. Same pronunciation again came. So, what alphabet? Which alphabet will come here? E, because these two have a same pronunciation. So, like this way, we can identify, we can find this, how to find this rhyme scheme. So, what is the rhyme scheme here? A, B, here again C, B, D, E, F, and again E. So, rhyme scheme is A, B, C, D, D, E, F, E. This is the rhyme scheme of this stanza. Stanza number 1. So, if pronunciation are same, we'll write the same letter, same sound of the alphabet. If pronunciation is changed, so we'll write the next alphabet of the letter C. So, this is the rhyme scheme of the first stanza. Now, second is rhyming words. I said, if pronunciation are same, so that become the rhyming words. Which pronunciation are same here? B and D. sound like spheres and tears. Both pronunciations are same. So it become what? The rhyming word. So you will write here what? Here spheres and tears. This is the first rhyming word. Another answer there, way and overhead. Same pronunciation we have. So you will write the second rhyming word, that is the way and overhead. Understood? So, like this way you can get its rhyming word also. Students, so we have find here what? Rhyme scheme and rhyming words. By the rhyme scheme, you can write here rhyming words, because I say here pronunciation are same of every word, that it becomes the rhyming word in this kanji. So, here we can see the rhyming words also. Now, see, third point is personification. What is personification here? Something is personified. Here, we can say, what personified here? Darkness. This word here, what is personification? I said, person, melancholy darkness. Here, darkness word, this darkness word, darkness is a non-living things we can say. If non-living things used as a living things, that will get become the personification. Remember this. So, what is personification here? Non-living things used as a living things, or living things used as a non-living things in the line, that becomes the personification. Say here, melancholy darkness. Darkness is a non-living things, but here in the next line, what the poet says, darkness generally weeps. You people know that human being can weep. Weeps means what? Crying. Human being can cry. Or living things can be crying. But here the poet is right. What? Non-living things is crying there. So it becomes the personification. Here darkness personified with the human beings, with the living things, that become the example of personification. So what you will write here? Darkness, melancholy darkness. And in the bracket you will write there, darkness is personified with the human ability, with the whips. It means here darkness cannot write here as a living things, but here the poet has used as a living things, because he said darkness is crying because of the rainy tears, and tears also he has used here. So tears also personified with the rain drops, right? Drops. We can say here human beings tears we can write here, but here the poet is used for the darkness. It is what it is doing here, it is weeping here. So here that is a personification used. Then transferred epithet. Transferred epithet means what here? Transferred epithet means here adjective and noun. You people know that parts of speech. Adjective used with the noun. Here the poet also had used the adjective with the noun, but it uses not for the noun, for the other things. So we'll see example here. What? See here, melancholy darkness, this whole word. Melancholy, here this word melancholy is used for the sadness, but this melancholy, it is an adjective, right? We can say adjective, and darkness, it's a noun. Right? Here, melancholy is used with the noun, but it is not used for the noun. It is used for the people. Right? So, that becomes the transferred epithet. So, melancholy word, it is an example of the transferred epithet. I say here, melancholy is an adjective. It is used with the noun, but it is not used for the noun, right? So that becomes the example of transferred epithet. Understood? So this is the example of transferred epithet. We have used 4 points here. Next, metaphor. Metaphor means what here? Metaphor means things or any qualities which are unlike. See, here, what is a metaphor? We can say humid shadows. Humid shadows means here, clouds. Understood? So, what is the example? This humid shadows, it's a clouds. So, that becomes the example of metaphor. So, you will write here, humid shadows. refers to the clouds up in the sky. And you can say human cells over all the spheres, right? So here clouds are become their action, because clouds are covered what the overall the sky, and it because of that the stars become invisible. So here we can see the example of metaphor, that is the human shadows. It refers to the clouds. Next, on about the poya, what is it? It is a new figure of speech for you people. What is onomatopoeia here? It means it is the word which gives the meaning of a sound. Here, pattern word, pattern means word, ringing sound. And but here it is given in the form of word, right? So students, here the pattern word, it is an example of onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia means what? It is the sound only. And which word here given the sound? It is the pattern. Understood. So it means pattern word giving a meaning of a sound, that will become the example of onomatopoeia. Students, so we have completed here sixth point. Now last point is alliteration. Alliteration means what? You people know that repetition of consonant sound. In every poem we have seen this point. By the poet it is used there. Repetition of consonant sound. Here we see its example. See, where we can find the repetition of consonant sound? In alphabet we know that 5 vowels we have, and rest of all that become the that is the consonant. So what is the consonant sound here? First of all, in the first line we can see humid and hover. Both word in the beginning of these words we can see same consonant sound here given. So how you will write here? Alliteration, you will make their title. Two words you will write here, humid and hover. Underline these two words, and in front of these two words you will write in a phonetic way, in a sound, right? Which sound repeated here? X sound repeated here. So this becomes the example of alliteration. X sound repeated. Now see here also, steady spheres. S sound repeated here, right? Then another word is also there. Place and pillow. P sound repeated here. P. So here, next also here, lie and listening. L sound repeated here. L. So you can see here many examples of alliteration. Alliteration means what? Repetition of a consonant sound. So here in the first stanza we have seen 7 points. First rhyme scheme, second is the rhyming words, personification, transferred epithet, metaphor, onomatopoeia and alliteration. Again I am explaining, the rhyme scheme is A, B, C, D, D, E, F, E. Same pronunciation are there, so same alphabet will come. If pronunciation are changed, so next alphabet will come. From the pronunciation we will get the rhyming words. Third is personification, darkness personified here, right? Personification, darkness. So here it becomes darkness word, it gives a example of personified. Darkness is personified what? Here the sadness. Transferred epithet means what? Adjective which is used with the noun, but it is not used for the noun. It is used for the someone else. What? Here, melancholy word here, it is not used for the darkness. Darkness is a noun and melancholy is an adjective, but it is used for the paper, right? So here it becomes the example of transferred epithet. Metaphor, humid shadows. Metaphor, what is the example of metaphor? Humid shadows means for two things or any things or quality which is unlike. So humid shadows, it is reverse, or it gives the example of with the clouds in the sky. Next, onomatopoeia, it gives a sound. A word which is used for the sound that becomes the example of onomatopoeia. Pattern word is here which gives the example of onomatopoeia. Alliteration means what? Repetition of consonant sound. So here few examples we got here for the alliteration, for the rhyme scheme, for the words, personification, transferred epithet and metaphor. So this is the first stanza only. So let's see next second.